So in this video, I'm going to talk about how to find semantic keywords. As we already know, what are semantic keywords, what are its important, and what are the strategies to do semantic SEO. Okay, so now how to find your semantic keywords which you can use to boost your semantic SEO. Hello friends, I'm Shivani Goel. Welcome in WsCube Tech. So let's start with the process of finding your semantic keywords. So just to find your semantic keywords means your related keywords, here we can use Google related search suggestion. What is this Google related search suggestion? After a user search on Google, the search engine will return a list of related searches at the bottom of the search page. Let me show you how you can figure out this. Okay, just to get your related searches, here you have option on Google if you simply mention any query. Let's suppose if I simply mention one query, that is digital marketing. Okay, so this is your query, and when you simply go at the bottom, here you can see your related searches, that is digital marketing course, digital marketing meaning, digital marketing company, types of digital marketing, digital marketing benefits, business, digital marketing PDF, digital marketing concepts. So these are the related query of your primary keyword digital marketing. So here you can get an idea about your related keyword, or you can say your semantic keywords. Okay. Next, after your Google related search suggestion, next we have people also ask feature. So what is this people also ask feature? Here, just to figure out your related keywords, after your Google search suggestion, now the next thing we have is our people also ask. Let's suppose here for this particular query, if you simply mention your query on Google search engine, then you have a box that is people also ask. It means that these are the queries which, in spite of your primary keyword, people also use to search this particular information. Like, what is an example of digital marketing? What are the types of digital marketing? How do I start digital marketing? Which digital marketing is best? So these are the people also ask suggestion box where you can get an idea about the related searches. Okay. So after your people also ask feature, the next thing we have is a Google search result. So what is this Google search result? Let's suppose for the search term, how to start a daycare will bold the term childcare, opening a daycare, and the actual search term. So when you simply search any particular keyword on Google search, in that case, bolding the direct search term or bold any related term that appear in the meta description, here you can get idea about your related search. Okay? Let me show you how you can do that. Let's suppose here in digital marketing, here you can see that we have some terms like advertising delivering through digital channels such as search engines, website. Okay, here you can see some of the content in the bold letter. Okay, after that we have some results also available there. Here you can see some terms in the bold letter, that is your digital marketing. Here again is your digital marketing. So whatever be the search term you are finding in the bold, you can use that. Here you can see that marketing is in bold. It means that marketing is a related search term here. Okay, in the same way, here you can see in your other map, just like here you can see internet marketing. This is also your related term here. And when you simply open this internet marketing from here, whatever be the keyword you are getting in the bold, these all are the related searches here. Okay, let us suppose here I simply open this Wikipedia of digital marketing. So whatever be the search term you are finding in the bold letter, these all are your related searches here. Okay, just like your digital marketing, here you can see these are also your related searches. You can also use them as in semantic keywords here. Okay, so after your Google search result, Next thing we have is our Google Ads tool. With the help of Google Ads, we can use a tool which is known as Keyword Planner here. With the help of Keyword Planner, you can do keyword research. In our keyword research tool, we will learn how to use Keyword Planner. So, with the help of this particular Keyword Planner, you can get idea about your primary keyword and as well as your related keywords here. Okay, so intro the planner, people can learn about the popularity and the search rate of that particular keyword they are considering. That also help marketers to better understand and the type of searches. Okay, so the next tool we have is our Google Trends. Google Trends is one of the tools given by Google which provides some helpful information for finding keywords. Users can uncover patterns within the searches, and the trends also provide information about related searches and the topics. Okay, let me show you how Google Trends help us. For your Google Trends, you have to simply type on Google, that is Google Trends. Okay, this is your Google Trends here. Now you have to simply click on that. Okay, then you have to mention your search item here. Here I mention my keyword, that is digital marketing. Okay, so corresponding to your particular keyword here, you can see data of past 12 months, or you can also edit that in categories in your web search. You can also do comparison. Okay, you can also do your result as reason wise. You can also see result as your related topic about this particular keyword, who are ranking now, and your related queries, from where you can get idea about your related searches of this particular keyword. Okay, so after your Google Trends, you can see result like this, like we have related topic and the related queries there. Okay, and we can simply list down all these query in our semantic keyword list, and from there we can figure out. Okay, next tool we have is Answer the Public. This is a tool which can generate a list of questions and the list of prepositional phrases that allows you to create powerful list of multi-level latent semantic index keyword. Okay, with the help of this particular tool, you can get an idea about all the questions which is related to your particular keyword. Okay, let me show you that. For this, you have to simply mention on Google, that is Answer the Public. Answer the Public. Okay, here you have to simply mention your keyword here, that is digital marketing. Okay, now you have to click on search. After that, when you simply scroll down, you can see that we have a list of questions available in the graphic form. Like digital marketing, who digital marketing, which digital marketing course is best. So from there you can get an idea about related searches. Okay, here you can see visualization of your data in the form of alphabetic. You can also figure out these are the questions here. Okay, so these are the related searches here. Okay, so by this way you can explore your semantic keyword list. Okay, so after your Answer the Public, the next we have how are semantic keywords used for SEO. As we already know how to find semantic keywords here. So now the question is, how are semantic keywords used for SEO? To determine your primary keywords, determine your core keywords, make a list of thematically related keywords here, and make a list of the stamp keywords that answer such a question. Okay, so these are the tools which you can use to figure out your semantic keywords. So thank you so much for watching this video.